Hi, my name is Anna and I'm from Elastic Email Team. And today I'm going to show you how to work with our email automation feature. It's easy, it's simple, and it only takes a few steps to set up. So let's start. First, I'm going to tell you a few things about email automation, about what it is. So email automation is essentially an email sequence that is sent to a specific contacts in your list. It is triggered by a particular event established by you, and it's a way to create emails that reach the right people with the right message at the right time without doing the work every time. Now, it's important to point out that the Elastic email automation feature is only available for the unlimited pro plans. And with that being said, let's start doing the automation. So when you first log in to your Elastic email account, you will be able to see the automation tab on the left-hand side menu. So simply click on that. Here you will be able to see all your existing and published automations, all your work in progresses, drafts, and you will be able to create a new automation. So let's do that now. Let's click on the Create Automation button, and that will show us a new screen. This will open a new screen where you will be able to create your first automation. Let's first name the automation. I'm going to name it Onboarding Process. Now, you can make your automation as simple or as complicated as you want. It all depends on you and what you wish for. And I'm just here to show you like the basics of creating the first automation. So, the Elastic email operates based on the plus sign. So this one right here, and you can add designated steps. So when you click on the plus sign, there are four options. There is an email option, which you can create an email to send to your contacts. There's a delay where you can set up after what time a new action will happen. There is a condition, which shows you like the option if a person opened an email or if they clicked on a link in a designated email and what actions will be taken later. And then there is action, so what will happen after a person receives an email or opens a specific link. I tend to be forgetful at times. I prepared myself a little, setup. It's good to be prepared. And, I just need to write stuff down. So let's start with the automation trigger. Let's click on that and select a trigger. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on a contact joins a list, and we are going to select a new contact. So every time a new contact will join this list, this automation will start. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click here and select an email. So we will send them a welcome email, and you can add a subject line here, and you can write down from whose is this email from, and then we can do a little bit of more action. So let's click on the plus again, and let's add a condition. Let's select a condition if the email was opened. In that case, we have to click on the email activity and select a role if the email was opened. So did contact open an email? Now let's move on to the yes category and let's click on a plus. Let's set up a delay and let's wait for, let's give them 8 hours. After those 8 hours, we will send them another email with first steps guide. As you can see, I have already some emails created here, and you can do so as well, or you can create an email while you are creating an automation. I just find that creating an email and lists first is just easier for me. Now let's move on to the no section. If a person didn't open our welcome email, let's give them a little bit more time and let's set the delay again for 8 hours. And now let's send a follow-up email. There we go. This is a follow-up email. So let's send this one to them and let's set up another condition if this email was also opened. So in this case, we again have to click on the email activity and need to select a role if the email was opened. And now we also have two options, yes or no. Let's move on to the yes. Again, if the email was opened, I want to give them, I think, around 12 hours. of weight, and then we will send them another email titled Tips and Tricks. And I have that email ready right here. Okay, so what will happen if the contact didn't open this email as well? What we can do is we can set up a little bit longer delay because this person doesn't. What we can do is we can set up a little bit longer delay. So let's give them 24 hours and let's send them an email that will be called, "Are you still interested?" Since they didn't open any of our emails, I just want to know if they are still interested in our email, if, you know, they want to receive it. So what we're going to do is we're going to set up another condition right here. And this condition will be a little bit different condition. And I'm going to do a slightly different condition because I'm going to create an email activity. And I'm going to set up if they had any link clicked. Now there's a few options. It's either it was opened, any link click, or a specific link clicked. In the email, "Are you interested?" I put only one link, which was the unsubscribe button. And if they clicked on the any link, then I'm going to create an action and I'm going to remove them from a list. Because if they click unsubscribe, they don't want to be informed about what we are doing and our tips and tricks. So I want to give them an option to remove from a new contacts list. Now, let's move on to did a contact open an email? And if they clicked no, we're going to set up an action to add to a list called re-engagement onboarding. So we will contact this customer at the later time. We're going to send a different emails or set up a different automation. We can do the same with the no option. We can also create an action and we can also add to a list re-engagement onboarding. So this is pretty much how the automation works. Again, you can do as simple or as complicated automation as you want. At any point in the automation process, if you want to delete anything, you simply click on the X. However, please know that when you click on the X somewhere at the top, or you know, you will want to delete the delay that is here, this will remove everything that happened after. So if I'm going to click here and I'm going to delete this delay option, it is going to delete everything that happened after this, this whole branch. So just be aware of that. Okay, so that's pretty much it. That's how you create an email automation in our Elastic Email Dashboard. It's really simple. It doesn't really require anything from you. And I hope that you enjoyed this video. Bye.